Use the equation to create a table of points and graph. Connect the points with a smooth curve. All right, so we have y equals x squared minus 6. So what I'll do is create a table of x and y, and then the ordered pairs, x comma y. So I'm just going to use the values of x. I'm going to use negative 3, negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1, 2, and 3. And then the y values, let's see, I'd have negative 3 squared minus 6, and that's 9 minus 6, which is 3. Similarly, I'd have negative 2 squared minus 6. 4 minus 6 is negative 2. Negative 1 squared minus 6 is 1 minus 6, negative 5. And 0 squared minus 6 is negative 6. 1 squared minus 6 is 1 minus 6, which is negative 5. 2 squared minus 6, that's 4 minus 6 is negative 2. And 3 squared minus 6 is minus 6 is 9 minus 6, which is 3. Writing these as ordered pairs, I'd have negative 3, 3, negative 2, negative 2, negative 1, negative 5, 0, negative 6, 1, negative 5, 2, negative 2, 3, 3. I'm going to use a standard scale on each axis. So each mark means 1, that I'll mark every other point, or every other mark on the axes. Plot the points in orange. Negative 3, 3. Negative 2, negative 2. Negative 1, negative 5. 0, negative 6. 1, negative 5. 2, negative 2. 3, 3. So if I look at these points, they do not appear to be collinear. And so I will draw a smooth curve, so no jagged edges here. A smooth curve that goes through these points. And I'll do my best to draw this. All right, and so there's the shape that we get. And in fact, this shape is called a parabola. And you'll learn more about parabolas in a later course. Y equals the absolute value of x minus 2. So I'm going to start by creating a table of values. I'm actually going to use those same values for x that we used in the previous one. So negative 3, negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1, 2, and 3. All right, so y would be the absolute value of negative 3 minus 2. Negative 3 minus 2 is negative 5, and the absolute value of that is 5. So I'd have that negative 3, 5. Y would equal the absolute value of negative 2 minus 2. That's negative 4. The absolute value of negative 4 is 4. And let's continue. Absolute value of negative 1 minus 2. Negative 1 minus 2 is negative 3. The absolute value of negative 3 is 3. Absolute value of 0 minus 2. 0 minus 2 is negative 2. The absolute value of negative 2 is 2. The absolute value of 1 minus 2. 1 minus 2 is negative 1. The absolute value of that is 1. And the absolute value of 2 minus 2. 2 minus 2 is 0, and the absolute value of 0 is 0. And x equals 3, the absolute value of 3 minus 2. Well, 3 minus 2 is 1, and the absolute value of 1 is 1. So now if you looked at those first, 6 points, it appears that they were just decreasing by one each time, but then notice that last one, it changes. Let's go a little bit further. Let's go with x equals 4 and x equals 5, just to get a couple more points in our sample. So if we chose 4 for x, we'd have the absolute value of 4 minus 2. 4 minus 2 is 2. The absolute value of 2 is 2. And absolute value of 5 minus 2. 5 minus 2 is 3, and the absolute value of 3 is 3. So we have some points here. Let's see what happens when we graph this. So let me set my scale. Everything looks like we can use a standard scale. So again, like I've done before, I will just mark every other mark. And I'll plot the points in orange. Let's see, we have negative 3, 5, negative 2, 4, negative 1, 3, 0, 2, 1, 1, 2, 0, 3, 1, 4, 2, 5, 3. And you know, we could guess and say, well, the next point would be 6, 4, and we would be correct. And we could go on from there. So we appear to get a V shape out of this. And so I'll go ahead and draw that V shape. I'm going to use a straight edge here to try and make it look right. All right, and so there's the graph that we would get from that equation.